Today's project is painting Venice lace and cotton doilies. You'll notice that I said painting rather than dyeing because we're going to use paint which lays on the surface of the fiber rather than a dye which creates a chemical bond. The products we're going to be using are both water-based. One is Jacquard's Dynaflow and the other is Ranger's Adirondack Color Wash Sprays. I'm going to show you a couple of different techniques and neither require that you're Picasso, so don't fret about it. One of them is very much paint by number. We're going to use the motifs on the Venice lace and on the appliques to determine where to put color. And in the other, we're going to just splash color on randomly and dye large lengths of lace or whatever it is that we want to do. This is another fun, easy technique that you can in fact do with the kids if you want. Just wrap them in an apron and everybody will have a good time. Alrighty, I'm set up to work. I have color wash here, Dynaflow. I have a plastic palette that I'm going to use to mix water with the Dynaflow and the color wash. I have a container of water, I have brushes, and I have an assortment of Venice lace. Some of them are ones that we sell by the yard, as you see here. I have this one that's really pretty. We have some smaller ones. The nice thing about Venice lace is that it's available in a huge assortment of styles and widths. We have appliques that sort of run the gamut. We have some leaves and flowers. There's a heart. If you saw the Easter egg tutorial, then you know that we have not only this flower, but we have dragonflies, which I have one right here that you can see. So there's a couple of different ways that we're going to do this. We're going to start first by painting on lace that's dry. This is the palette that I like to use when I'm working with this process. Each of the wells in here can be used to hold a different color, so I'm just going to show you what I do, which is I'm going to use a bunch of green to start with, so I'm going to mix a fair amount of that. All I've done is put some water in here, and I'm going to take some of the Adirondack color wash. This one happens to be lettuce, and I'm going to let a little bit run off the end of this sprayer into there until I get a depth of color that I like. I'm a fan of pastels and more subtle colors than I am of bright jewel tone colors, so if you want bright, you can either thin these with only a little bit of water, or you can use them straight from the bottle. I'm just going to use the end of the brush and mix this up, and I'm pretty certain that that's a color that I'm going to be happy with. I'm going to start with this leaf. And I'm not going to pre-wet this leaf. I'm going to use it just as it is. And I'm going to simply apply color on here. And as you can see, the color does not move all that much because the water can only spread as far as it will go. Because there's no water in this already, there's nothing to aid the spread of the color. That's pretty well covered with green now. What I'm going to do is take this and just see if I can add a little bit of deeper green to the veining. So I'm going to put a little bit of this green in a well. I'm going to mix very little water with it, and I'm going to use a fine brush to apply it. Just going to touch this color down because this is wet now, the color is going to bleed. And so if you're careless, the color is going to end up bleeding a little bit beyond where you want it to go. As you can see, those veins start to stand out a little bit more and you add a little bit more dimension and detail to the piece. Here. For this piece, you can see I've already put some turquoise color on here, and this also, again, is a dry piece that I'm starting with. I'm just going to mix a fair amount of this color because I have a fair amount of area to cover here. And all I'm doing is taking the back of a paintbrush and dipping it in the bottle of Dynaflow, which gets my color into that water, mixes up my diluted solution. And because this is a good sized piece, I'm going to use a bigger brush. Just going to put that in there and start applying the color. This is nice if you need a short length of a very specific color for a project, or even a long length if you wanted to. I guess the point is that you can get virtually any color because there are so many colors in the Dynaflow line, and in the Color Wash line, your palette is pretty much unlimited. The color I'm going to use now is the Color Wash Wild Plum, and I'm going to come in and start it over here. And then I'm going to bring it across and I'm going to deliberately overlap this teal. And what you're going to see is the magic that happens when these two colors start to mix. You're going to get a third color. And in addition to that, because this is still very wet because I just put the teal on, you're going to see how quickly this wild plum is going to bleed across. So here we are applying it where the lace is dry. You can see what happens. The color starts to pull itself across here. It starts to wick into the liquid that's already there. And you see the blend that happens now. We have the teal mixing with this wild plum, and we get this kind of grapey purple effect, which I think is pretty interesting. So not only can you mix multiple colors in your palette as you're preparing to dye, you can also come across and you can let this blending happen kind of spontaneously as you're working. What I'd like to show you now is what happens when you take a piece that's wet, as this cotton doily is, and you apply color wash that's been blended with water versus the same color that's straight from the bottle. And this is Adirondack color wash in the color Purple Twilight. Let me get this out of the way. Because we have a big area to cover, I'm going to go back to my larger flat brush, and I'm going to come in and I'm going to dip my brush in the color that's been diluted with water, and I'm going to lay it right on here, and you can see what happens as this color starts to bleed. You can watch it creep across the doily here, and when I come back and I put a little bit more on, you can see it begin to puddle underneath, but you also watch it travel across, and the color is fairly subtle. By comparison, when you see how dark the color that's straight from the bottle is, you'll understand what I mean. Let me dry off my brush, and I'm going to dilute that color. Now I'm going to come in and I'm going to pick up Purple Twilight that's right out of the bottle, and I'm going to apply it over here, and you're going to see quite how strong the difference is. You see, this now looks like grapes, as opposed to this, which is much lighter. Let me grab a little bit more color. And you can see quite how strong that is. I'm going to show you the paint by number technique that I talked about a few minutes ago. This motif is already wet. I've dried it off a little bit. It's not sopping wet. And I'm going to come in and I'm just going to paint this a little bit at a time. And you can watch as the colors kind of spread. But the nice thing is that the design kind of dictates where you apply the color. I'm choosing to make this stylized tulip yellow, and it's really simple to come in here and just lay this color down. Okay, now with that done, I'm just going to rinse this brush out. I'm going to come in with a little bit of green, and by the way, that yellow is the color wash in butterscotch that I've obviously mixed with water. And I'm going to come back with the same green that I've been using, which is color wash lettuce, also mixed with water. And I'm going to lay the green in here, following the pattern on here. It just dictates where I'm going to place the colors. I'm going to take a little bit of the straight lettuce and I'm going to just put it on my palette here. I'm going to use it directly out of the bottle. I want to paint the stems darker green just to give a little bit of dimension to what we have going on here. And I'm going to use this tiny little brush that's called a spotter brush. I'm not going to dilute this with water. I'm just going to pick it straight up and very carefully apply this so that my stems are a darker color. Now, because this is wet, there is going to be a little bit of movement, but it's not dramatic. I'm going to grab a little bit of the butterscotch. I want to do the same thing to those buds. I want to pick up some of the darker color to just highlight them so that they stand out a little bit. And if you watch, I'm just going to touch this to the center and it's going to basically flow outward. I don't have to do very much at all, just let the color travel on its own. A tulip.